All right, what's going on? Today, we're gonna talk about something that's a little bit more overlooked, but I hear it come up all the time. You'll hear certain anglers, whether it be elite anglers or be people that are just, you know, local guys or some of my buddies that I talk to, they seem to struggle on different types of bodies of water. And, you know, you can't fault them for that. I definitely do as well. There's certain types of bodies of water that I really just seem to understand when I get there. And there's certain types of bodies of water that I really feel like I have to just commit to an area because I really don't understand the way the fish sit up all throughout the waterway. So a lot of times whenever you have a lot of history or you really understand the way that a river or a lake sets up, you can really run around and do a lot of stuff and kind of run a pattern from one end of the lake all the way to another. But whenever you don't really understand it, it's really important just to find an area, stay put, and make sure you can generate some bites if you're going to try to do well in a tournament. So obviously, if you're out fun fishing, you should not do that. If you're trying to learn, you're trying to improve, you should run around, fish as much new stuff with as many different techniques you possibly can, and try to get a better understanding of exactly what's going on in those tournaments on a given day, but or on that lake on a given day, or on, you know, just kind of understand how they set up in general. But what we're going to talk about is the differences in lakes and rivers. And you can obviously tell the difference in a river. We're on a river today, and you can tell the difference on a lake. It's big, expansive, wide open. But that's not always the case. On the Tennessee River, it can still be really wide open, really expansive, but the fish still set up more like a river system. So one thing that I would say is fishing the river systems that I have close to the house, and that's one thing that's really unique about where I grew up, is we have lakes that if you run 5 or 6 miles, all of a sudden turn into rivers. So the fish will set up completely different on just 5 or 6 miles apart on the exact same day. And sometimes you'll play that to your advantage. You might run down here and try to fish for the lake fish early because you feel like you can catch them in the lake the way they kind of set up early. Or you can run up the river and fish there early, then run down to the lake later. And there you can commit to one or the other. It's a really unique thing that you kind of get to sample it all in one day. But the top few differences that I have between lakes and rivers is, number one, in a river system, it seems like the fish are a lot more polarized. It seems like you're not gonna have to trick them. They're either gonna bite or they're not, and it's big time about covering water and trying to find those areas where the big fish just seem to always get. That's one thing about rivers also, is they really seem to replenish. If you find a perfect little spot, more times than not, the fish is gonna be there day after day after day after day. Whereas on a lake, a lot of times the fish seem to be a little bit more nomadic or pelagic, whatever you want to call it, where they'll really kind of roam around and stay on the bait, and they'll kind of get in open water sometimes, they'll pull under a dock sometimes, they'll get super shallow sometimes, and it really is conditional. So I honestly kind of like fishing both of them, but I really do, whenever I'm fishing a lake type scenario, I'm always going to try to run, you know, the conditions and try to fish exactly what I think is happening right now, because I know how fast those fish are repositioning. Whenever you're fishing in a river, like what we have today, we have some relatively clear water and current coming by. I know what kind of baits I'm gonna kind of choose whenever the water's this clear, and then I kind of feel like I have a good understanding of where those fish are gonna be because there's current and the fish don't have a ton of options about where exactly they wanna hide. They kind of have to get where they have to get. You know, they can't just sit out in the middle of the river channel. It doesn't matter if the shad swim out there for a little while or what, the fish might run out there and chase them, but they still have to get behind something because they're not just gonna sit in the middle of that water in the current. And that's one of the biggest players that we have, is we have a lot of current in these river systems. But another thing I'll say is, typically, in the river systems, it seems like the fish want to eat a little bit smaller baits. It just seems like those fish that have to stay on the bank, they don't spend their entire life chasing around the biggest bait they can find. Whereas the fish that live in the lakes, and some of the biggest lakes in the country, like Lake Fork and stuff like that, a lot of those really big fish spend their entire life, except when they're spawning, trying to stay as close as possible to the biggest bait they can find. So that's one of the biggest differences, is exactly what you're trying to do. The river fish, like I said, are a little bit more polarizing. They feel like you're not really gonna have to trick them that often. The lake fish, you can downsize and get more bites from time to time. And you can definitely do that in a river also. 100% you can. But in the lakes, it really seems like when they're firing, you can catch them big time on whatever the biggest bait you want to. And whenever they're not firing, it can be extremely tough and you really gotta downsize. So it also seems like to me, in the river system, it's a onesie-twosie kind of a deal. That means it's a one fish at a time. Every fish has a different temperament, every fish sets up a little bit different, and every fish, whenever you get them to bite, it does not always mean it's a pattern. Sometimes it just means there was one fish in this one spot because this one spot is a little bit unique. In a lake, when you get a bite or two, you can dang sure bet it's gonna be a pattern, and you can usually run that whenever you want to. So that's one of the biggest differences is, a lot of times in the river, you know, you can't think that you're on a pattern just because you got a bite or two. And that's something that I kind of fell victim to I still do it every now and then. You'll get a bite and you'll think, hey, I can run this. I know where another spot is like this. But unless it's exactly the same and has everything that lines up exactly the same, a lot of times it's kind of just a one kind of off chance thing like that. So in the lake, remember that whenever you start getting bites, you can run a pattern a whole lot more. Another thing, lakes tend to be clearer. That's just going to kind of be what it is. The river systems, they do clear up first, actually. The rivers will clear up first, but the lakes are usually going to be clearer more times than not. So that means a lot of times in lakes, it's going to have to be a lot more natural presentations. Pre-spawn, they'll still bite some of the bigger stuff, but your lake fishing, especially down here, is going to be a lot more about worms, jigs, cranking, stuff like that, that really, you know, imitates the shad or imitates the bait fish you're trying to imitate. It imitates them perfectly. In the river, a lot of times it'll stay a little more stained up. The fish will be a little bit not quite as smart, not quite as, you know, messed with. And that's kind of just my broad approaches to the way that I target rivers and the way that I target lakes. Now, I'll tell you just in general, the river system for me is going to be where I'm going to be the hotter it is and sometimes the colder it is. The thing about that is, whenever the bite gets extremely tough, like I said earlier, I really feel like I know where the fish have to be, because they have to be in a certain place. So if I feel like I know where they have to be when the bite gets tough, when it's super hot, or when the bite gets tough, when it's super cold, I can go there and I know I can put my bait in front of a bass. In the river system, that's just kind of how it is for me. Now, in the lakes, whenever there's a big migration, if there's a shad spawn, if there's bluegill beds, if the bass are moving up to spawn, if the bass are moving in the fall, whatever the big migration is, I'm almost always going to be in the lake type of area, because for one, I think it's got more of a population. For two, it almost always, on almost every single lake or river system or whatever, if there's a river that dumps into the lake has the bigger quality fish. The lower end of almost every lake has the biggest quality fish. So that's why when there's a giant migration, that's where I want to fish at. That's what I want to fish around. I want to stay around the biggest migration of fish whenever they're pulled up, and I feel like I can run a pattern and target them. So remember that the next time you're out on your local, small little local river or small little local lake, and it might be, you know, something that you kind of understand now. It might be something you already knew. That's just kind of what I have developed over the years. That's kind of my approach to where I'm going to start first off. And there can obviously always be deviations. That's what bass fishing is. Bass fishing is all about deviating. So obviously this is not going to be a rule or a law or something like that that the fish absolutely have to follow. But that's the basic guidelines. Hope y'all enjoyed that. I just kind of want to go through that because I've been hearing that so much about I struggle on this river system or I struggle on lakes. I seem to do better on rivers. And trust me, I'm with you. I've been through it myself too. So I hope that helps some of y'all. I appreciate y'all watching. If y'all like this type of video, leave a like. Hit that subscribe button. Me and Hunter's been fishing a whole lot lately. We got a lot of videos. We're going to start trying to post one every single other day. So keep checking back and hit that
every single other day.
Yeah, every single other day. We're going to try to post one every single other day. So hit that subscribe button and check back and come back and check out the rest of our videos. We appreciate it. We're about to go river fishing.